الحمد لله الحمد لله سابغ النعم ودافع النقم ومجلي الغمم وكاشف الظلم أعدل من حكم وحسيب من ظلم وولي من ظلم أحمده حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماوات وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء مولانا من شيء بعد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهه وعظيم سلطانه حمدا لا يحصيه عددا ولا يحيط به علما إلا هو السميع العليم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وخيرته من خلقه وصفيه من أنبيائه ورسله أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وجل الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك اللهم صل وسلم عليه وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين وعلى ذريته وآل بيته وعترته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته وتابعيهم ومن اتبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعلى والدينا ومشايخنا وأصحاب الفضل علينا وعلينا معهم صلاة وسلاما دائمين كاملين متلازمين إلى يوم الدين آمين يا رب العالمين. My brothers and sisters, we are in the month of Rajab. There is a historical event which took place in this blessed month, and that is Isra and Mi'raj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has described it in two surahs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. Which means Allah the Exalted. Exalted is He who took His servant Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by night from Masjid al-Haram, which is in Mecca, to Masjid al-Aqsa, which is in Palestine. من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. Surrounding or blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surrounding of Masjid al-Aqsa. لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. To show him of our great sign. Allah is إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. He is the hearing and he is the seeing. This journey of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam consisted of two parts. One part, the first part, it was a journey from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, from Mecca to Jerusalem, and that is called a night journey. Night traveling in Arabic language is called al-Isra. The second part of this blessed journey is actually an ascension from Masjid al-Aqsa to the heaven, and that is called Mi'raj, Uruj, to come up, to raise. My brothers and sisters, there are many things happen a year and a half before this journey, and that is necessary and important to review in order to understand the significance of Isra and Mi'raj. Many things happen a year and a half before this journey. Number one is that was the time when the disbelievers, the mushrikeen of Mecca, they increase torturing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion. They accelerated in punishment and torturing, giving hard time to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. While the Muslim will not allow at that time to fight back. But Allah says, فَعْفُوا وَاسْبَحُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Forgive and overlook unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send His commandment. And after this, during this period of time, one of his great support, his uncle, Abu Talib, he passed away. And after his death, the disbeliever became more to punish Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. Soon after the death of Abu Talib, Sayyida Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of Rasulullah, Ummul Mu'mineen, she also passed away. So the time was very difficult for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam because people are very dear to give hard time to Rasulullah. So under these circumstances, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam decided to go outside of Mecca to propagate the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he chose the valley of Taif. Because these were the people, distant relationship, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mother has some relatives and friends in Taif. And he was hoping that the people of Taif will accept the message and will welcome me. But you know what happened? People of Taif, they allow their children to stone the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was bleeding there. His shoes were filled up with blood. And in these circumstances, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, my brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was in Taif. He's bleeding. He's in difficult situation. And he took a refuge in one of the gardens. And the guy who took a pity on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and showed a little bit help to Rasulullah. At that time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibril alayhi salam with the Malik al-Jibal, with the angel of the mountain. And they asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you want, we can destroy and kill the people of Taif. But Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La, bal arju an yukhrij Allah min aslabihim man ya'budu Allah wahdahu wa la yushriku bihi shay'a." I hope, do not destroy these people. I hope that from the same people, from the same generation, another people will come who will worship Allah alone and who will not make any partner with Allah. And I have been sent as rahmatul lil alameen, mercy for mankind. I'm not sent as a punishment for the people. So because of this several event, same event, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this case, it is called in the book of the seeras, Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness, the year of sorrow. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came back to Mecca, now he was not allowed. He was considered a non-citizen of Mecca. People are not allowing you. You cannot enter to your city. Subhanallah. My brothers and sisters, at that time, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making dua, Allahumma ilayka ashku. ضعف قوتي وقلة حيلتي وهواني على الناس رب المستضعفين إلى من تكلني إلى بعيد يتجهمني أو إلى عدو ملكته أمري. سبحان الله. Beautiful dua. He's complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says in his dua, إن لم يكن بك علي غضب فلا أبالي. Oh Allah, if this is not your anger, then I don't care. He was thinking that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with me. People of Makkah do not allow me to enter. People of Ta'if rejected the message. And what they did with me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to give him a big reward. My brothers and sisters, at that time, after several attempts and negotiation with the people of Makkah, with one condition you can enter, you cannot preach anymore inside Makkah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted that and came in. And he was preaching outside of Makkah. He was waiting for the people. Da'wah, my brothers and sisters. And, you know, this hard time, Amr al-Huzn, the uncle is not there, the wife is not there. He's hopeless now. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to give him a big reward. And that was in the shape of Isra and Mi'raj. And let us describe that. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting in the masjid. Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam came and greeted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, asked him to make wudu, a fresh wudu, with the zamzam water. And after that he offered salah and two rakah. And the Prophet, Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, he brought a very horse, very fast horse, which is called Burat. And before that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was offered two cups, a cup of milk and a cup of wine. A cup of milk and a cup of wine. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he selected the cup of milk. And Jibreel alayhi salam told him, you have selected the right thing. You and your ummah will be on the right path. While we know rejecting the cup of wine because it's going to be forbidden later. And it is Ummul Khabais. It is the evil. It is mother of the all kind of evils. Remember, even in Makkah time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the wine in Quran, alcohol, different names. Allah says in Surah An-Nahl, تَتَّخِذُونَ مِنْهُ سَكَرًا وَرِزْقًا حَسَنًا. You take intoxication from it and there is a good food. The second time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they ask you about the wine and gambling. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الْخَمْرِ وَالْمَيْسِرِ قُلْ فِيهِمَا إِثْمٌ كَبِيرٌ وَمَنَافِعُ لِلنَّاسِ. They ask you about the wine, alcohol and gambling, lottery. Allah says, the sin is major, the sin is greater than its benefit. It's not prohibited at that time. Third time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَقْرَبُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَأَنْتُمْ سُكَارَىٰ. O you who believe, do not approach salah while you are in a state of intoxication or when you are drunk. The last time, four times, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly prohibited. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, innama al-khamru wal-maisru wal-as'an wal-ansab wal-azlam rijsun min amali shaytan, fashtanibu. Innama yuridu shaytan an yuqa'a baynakum al-adawata wal-bada'a fil-khamri wal-maisru wa yasuddakum an zikrillah. So at that time it was prohibited at all. Now, when before the journey, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not take a cup of this. My brothers and sisters, how many brothers and sisters, the Muslim brothers and sisters, some of us we are involved in buying and selling. Some of us we are involved in drinking. Some of us, which is clearly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned, we are living in this country does not mean that the law of the country allowed. It does not mean it is allowed by Allah in Quran. It is not. It is haram. Do not make things halal for yourself, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it haram. Take a step. make a tawbah, repentance, and give up for the sake of Allah. Allah will open the doors of halal rizq for you, my brother and sister. This was the first thing. Then Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam, he took our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's ascension from Masjid al-Aqsa to the first heaven, then to all the heavens, seven heavens, where he met some of the prophets and messengers. I'm not going to go in too much detail, just to remind you that on first heaven, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. On the second one, he met two prophets, Sayyidina Yahya ibn Zakariya alayhi salam and Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam. On the third one, he met Sayyidina Yusuf alayhi salam. On the fourth one, he met Sayyidina Idris alayhi salam. On the fifth one, he met Sayyidina Harun alayhi salam. On the sixth one, he met Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. And the last one, he met Abul Anbiya, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And he greeted to all of them, and they returned his greeting and confirmed their belief in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jibreel alayhi salam is the guide. He's guiding the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At one moment, they saw the angel of the hellfire. He was given a visit to Jannah as well. And also he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam requested Jibreel alayhi salam to let the Malik al-Nar, Malik al-Jahannam, the guardian of the hellfire, that angel, he asked him, requested him to let him view. And the angel of fire, he put the lid from the fire. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shown some sign, some example of those people who are committing sin. And there are a few sins in the book of Sirah are mentioned. Number one, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw some people whose lips were like camel and had fire in their hands. He saw them thrusting these fireballs in their mouths, and then these balls come out of their posteries. And he asked Jibreel alayhi salam, what is this it means? It was explained to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people are carrying the fireball in their mouth and coming out from their backside. He says, these are the people who dishonest whenever a amanah is given, a trust is given to them. And they are the people who show and the dishonesty to that. Those who committed khiyana. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw some people with very big bellies, big stomachs, and mad and thirsty camels were running over them. Some people have a big stomach, big bellies. Camels and mad and thirsty camels, they are running over them. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, Jibreel, what is this? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told that these are the people who were involved in usury, interest, riba, we call it sud. They were involved in this matter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. If you do not stop involving riba, then get ready to fight with Allah and His messengers. My brothers and sisters, we are involved, the Muslims. May Allah give us tawfiq to give up all these things. Number three, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also saw some people who had good fresh meal and also rotten stinking meals, laying close to them. They ate the rotten meals rather than the good fresh meals. He was explained that these are the people who abandon their lawful spouses, men who are married, and they commit zina with other women. This is this sin, major sin, my brothers and sisters. And all these Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala separately mentioned in the Quran. Khamr, riba, zina, all these. Allah says, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا. And how many people? Now shaitan beautified this. It's a major sin to them to have a boyfriend and girlfriend. And what is the purpose? Just to fulfill the sexual desires. This sin was shown to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as well. He also saw some people, they were tied with the trees inside the hellfire. And these are the people who disobey their parents. They are not dutiful to their parents. Their parents are in extreme hell and they do not take care of their parents. It's also shown. Also, those khatib, the one who gives khutbah, may Allah save each and every one of us. Some khatib, their tongue will be cut by scissors of fire. And they will be running around in the hellfire. They are the one who, those who invite other people to do good, and they forget themselves. They do not act upon. He was shown those who are stealing. He was also shown the sin that who backbite, who spy on one another. He also shown the sin, those people who do not pray 5 times a day. What is going to happen to them in the hellfire? My brothers and sisters, all these things were shown to the Prophet ﷺ. And when he came back, he showed and he explained this to his companion. After the seventh heaven, during this journey, Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam took him to Sidrat al-Muntaha, end of that, where Jibreel was not allowed to go. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beyond that. Subhanallah. What he saw. And what was the purpose of this journey? This part of journey, this mi'raj is mentioned in Surah Al-Najm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ وَمَا طَغَى لَقَدْ رَأَى مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِ الْكُبْرَى. The sight, the eyes of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not turn to another side. Usually when a person goes somewhere, a beautiful place, nice place, a palace, a huge palace. We look here and there, and here and there, because we are, sometimes people become unconscious. This was not the case with Rasulullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ. The eye did not transgress and did not turn aside. And Allah has said, لَقَدْ رَأَى مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِ الْكُبْرَى. He saw the major sign of his Lord, Ayat Rabbi al-Kubra. This was the reason for their journey. As Allah says in the beginning of Surah Al-Isra, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa alladhi barakna hawlahu linuriyahu min ayatina. The purpose of their journey, Allah says, we want to show him some of our sign. لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. And he did see those great, great signs. لَقَدْ رَأَى مِنْ آيَاتِ رَبِّهِ الْكُبْرَى. My brothers and sisters, it is important for the Prophet and Messenger, for their iman, to show them something special. I give you the example. If someone goes to the airport, and he comes out and he's saying to the people who are in the line, waiting, the checkpoint. And he says, oh people, I have seen a person inside. He was requesting to allow me to fly. But he's not allowed. He says, then send me back. I want to go back to my house. He said, no, you have this something which is illegal to carry with you. Oh people, if you, I have seen with my own eyes, what do you do? This messenger, He says to people, I have seen this with all my own eyes. If you have these things, if you have riba, if you have zina, if you have this sin, that sin, major sin, that's what is going to happen to you. So be careful. He mentioned before you go there. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He shows this sign to people, some of His prophet. Even to Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَذَلِكَ نُرِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ مَلَكُوتَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لِيَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُوقِنِينَ. To Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, لِنُرِيَكَ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا الْكُبْرَى. Some other great sign was shown to Musa alayhi salam, to Ibrahim alayhi salam as well. Because they have the knowledge of ilm al-yaqeen. Ilm al-yaqeen and ayn al-yaqeen. They have shown these things to make their iman stronger. And after that, when a person sees the great, great sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they come back to their people, they can easily tolerate the torture and the punishment of the people. Because they know the temporary. My brothers and sisters. Also during this gift, during this journey, some gifts were given to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number one is, whoever say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. This is one of the favor to the Ummah of Rasulullah. That even if you commit their sin, but eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take out the people whoever said La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Whoever said La ilaha illallah, eventually they will be taken out from the hellfire. Number two is the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah was given as a gift to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time. And we need to memorize that beautiful dua. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من الرسل وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. These two ayat were given as a gift to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Number three, he was given the order to pray 50 times a day, in 24 hours. Pray 50 times a day. He was coming, babe. He saw Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, the sixth one, remember. He said, go back to Allah. I have an experience with my people. They may not be able to pray 50 times a day. So several times he went back and forth, back and forth. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam was given, yes, 40 times, 30 times, 20 times, 10 times, and 5 times. Musa alayhi salam even asked him, go back and ask for more decreasement. He says, I shy to go back. I hesitate. I will ask my ummah to pray 5 times a day. It's not a problem. But look at my brother and sister. The ummah, some of us, wallahi, it is true. Some of us, we pray only you may see a person. I hope they might be praying in their homes. But some new faces, you pray, only see them on the day of Eid. Some of us only pray Yawm al-Jum'ah, Salat al-Jum'ah. Some people 2 times, 3 times a day. Very rare 5 times a day, my brothers and sisters. This is not like a zakah in Hajj. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned 2 times a dry ablution, tayammum. If you are not able to make wadu, Allah says make tayammum. But you must pray for salah. If you are sick and not able to pray while you are standing, sit down and pray. If you are traveling, join Zuhr and Asr, Maghrib and Isha and decrease the number of raka'at, but you must pray. You cannot escape. Remember when the Prophet ﷺ was departing from this dunya, the last word the Sahaba had noticed, As-salah, as-salah, wa ma malakat aymanukum. This is the message. It was given, and also my brothers and sisters, the Prophet ﷺ said, As-salatu mi'rajul mu'mineen. Subhanallah. You know mi'raj, Isra and mi'raj. Isra and mi'raj. Mi'raj means ascension, uruj, taraqi, advancement. Subhanallah. Augmentum. All these words, mi'raj, uruj. So the salah is your mi'raj. To connect yourself, to be in a high status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salatu mi'rajul mu'mineen. Also my brothers and sisters, when they came back, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he led the salah in Masjid al-Aqsa. And all the prophets and messengers were behind him. Which shows the oneness of the message, Tawheed. And the distinction of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam over other prophets and messengers. He became Imam al-Anbiya. When he came back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned that Laylam min al-Masjid is a nakira. Subhanallah alladhi asra bi'abdihi Laylam. He did not say even al-layl, the night, one of the night, and part of the night. And he came back to Makkah, and then he mentioned to people that I went last night, I went to Jerusalem, and I was taken to the heavens. People started making fun of this man. Look it. Didn't we tell you that this man is a man, Majnoon and Sha'ir and Ka'ir? Na'udhu billah. So some people, they went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he was not there at that time. Do you know what does your friend say about the last night journey? He said, no. What happened? They told him that he says that he went to Palestine, to Jerusalem, and to Masjid al-Aqsa, then he was taken to the heaven. That's what he is claiming. He said, إِنْ قَالَهَا فَقَدْ صَدَقْ. If he has said that, then he has spoken the truth. Subhanallah. He says, I believe more than that. And that was the moment he was given a title of As-Siddiq, a truthful. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. مَا عَرَفْتُ الْإِسْلَامَ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا كَانَتْ عِنْدَهُ لَهُ كَبْوَةٌ غَيْرَ أَبِي بَكْرٍ فَإِنَّهُ لَمْ يَتَلْعَفَ. Whenever I presented Islam to any people, everyone had to pause for a moment to think, except Abu Bakr. He did not even think. The moment I told him, I'm the messenger of Allah, and he said, Ashhadu annaka Rasulullah. My brothers and sisters, also this ayah, the first ayah of Surah Al-Isra, or Surah Bani Israel, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi layla min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Many lessons for us. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses the word abd, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi. He did not say asra bi nabihi or asra bi rasulihi or asra bi Muhammad. Exalted is he, the one who took his servant. Abd. It shows few things. Abd is consist of soul and body. You cannot say only body that this is abd. Or soul is his abd. So it was a physical journey. Some people may say it was a dream. No. It was tangible, physical journey of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Number two, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he went beyond Sidratul Muntaha, where Jibreel could not go. But he is still Abduhu wa Rasuluhu. Al-Abdu Abdun wa in tarafah. Wal-Rabdu Rabbun wa in tanazzal. Abd is Abd. Slave is slave. No matter. He goes beyond there. He was proud. A فلا أكون عبدا شكورا. عبد. Number two from this ayah, to love Masjid al-Aqsa, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give freedom to the people of Palestine so we can see and pray in Masjid al-Aqsa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهُ. Surrounding of Masjid al-Aqsa is blessed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them huriya, the freedom. So even you ask the Palestinian brothers and sisters, how difficult for them just to pray there. If they want to pray Salat al-Jum'ah, they have to claim from Thursday night that after Fajr we will leave to make Jum'ah there. May Allah make them, make it easy for them and make it easy for every Muslim to go and pray in Masjid al-Aqsa. Also to love the Masajid, my brothers and sisters, Allah will take His servant from Makkah to Jerusalem and then to the heavens. But Allah says, "Min al-Masjid al-Haram ila al-Masjid, min al-Masjid ila al-Masjid, from Masjid to Masjid." Then the ascension, which shows that your attachment with the Masajid. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "A man whose heart is attached with the Masajid, wa rajulu qalbuhu mu'allaqun bil Masajid, he will be given a special treatment on the Day of Judgment." And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people and give us tawfiq to understand the significance and the importance of Isra and Mi'raj. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow those teachings which were taught and which were given to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il muslimin. الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيبنا وحبيب رب العالمين. أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم. لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا مبتلا إلا عافيته، ولا مجاهدا إلا نصرته، ولا مظلوما إلا أيدته، ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا قضيتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أيد الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم واستغفروه لذنوبكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. وأقم الصلاة.